my name is Marjolaine, and I'm the CEO and co-founder of JAM. I'm very happy to be here. So JAM is the first lifestyle conversational media exclusively on Messenger, designed to inspire millennials, so young people, to do more things with their everyday life. So just to give you a quick overview of JAM, JAM receives today an average of 3 messages per second, and it reaches almost 200,000 users in France. So I just wanted to start with a quick overview of the chatbot craze that we've been living over the past 2 years, where everyone wanted to have a chatbot, create a chatbot, sell you a chatbot, with this amazing promise that seemed almost too good to be true, that was, I can help you with anything, and you might even fall in love with me. So the her scenario, like this extension of you, this mega assistant to which you can talk to about anything, either under your personal life, professional life, and I would just help you with everything and talk to you and know you better than your friends or your partner. But that was too good to be true, unrealistic, deceptive, but mainly not just because of the technology, but it was something that even the users didn't want. Like, you could tell a user, hi, I can help you with anything, like, how can I help you with? And it's a blank page, and no one wants that. It's too much pressure, too much creativity to ask people. And they just didn't know what was the limits of the bot, and the experience resulted to be completely deceptive and what not what they wanted. So we've seen over the past year and month a bit of very concrete, specific use case that worked much more than the I can help you with anything. It was the customer support after purchase, a new type of marketing channels, games, specific operations. But what they had in mind, like what they had in common, and what we learned as chatbot makers, was that a good conversation goes both ways. And the chatbot, at least at first, should lead the conversation. You should not tell your users, ask me anything, I can help you with anything, and hey, just be creative and we'll see where it goes. And sometimes, and more often than not, it goes nowhere. The bot should lead the conversation. So with that in mind, I think it's a clear opportunity, that it's a good opportunity for media to come to the bot landscape. Because if you have something that should lead the conversation and bring content, then it's a great opportunity for media. Why do media need to reinvent themselves? And I'm especially talking about media that needs to recommend things instead of just providing any type of content, but that needs to understand the users and recommend things to them. It's because the content selection is too wide today. Either we're talking about movie selection, books selection, trips, destinations. The content selection is simply too wide for a paper or just simple media. There is, and therefore, a need for personalization. And also, reading a media is a passive action. You are you in front of your computer or a paper magazine, and you're just reading all the contents that is being given to you. It's just a passive action. And they tell they are interactive because you can like or comment, but to us, it's just not enough. And also, something that is, I think, interesting is that 70% of the people don't know where they've read a piece of content. Because they came to the media through social media, through a newsletter, through a friend, they remember what is the piece of content, but they don't remember where they read it, because it's not what matters. What matters is not the content, it's the media. So if we just take a few years back, and even today, we have paper media. So it's magazine, a few actors, mainly high fidelity from customers, because it was subscription model, like you could get it in your mailbox, or you would buy the same media over and over. And it's a limited number of articles, so you know which one you like every month, every week, every day, you read them, but it's limited. Then we had online media. So it was, at first, it was just bringing the paper experience online, the digital. So it's just you go on a website, instead of browsing the pages, you would just scroll, click, but it didn't bring much, you know, novelty to the user experience. And there are still many problems of the discoverability of the content. You have to scroll, you have to click. But even if the experience improved through video, sound, a bit of interaction, it's still mainly the same. It's top-down information that you have to scroll yourself. I'd like to think that a good conversation is worth 1,000 clicks, and that conversation is an amazing opportunity to go way further with the experience of media than paper and just simple website or blogs. The next generation of media, I believe, will be conversational. There will be many formats, videos, sounds, GIF, whatever. It's not what matters. What matters is that the guiding thread, the core of the experience, is the conversation. The conversation from the content and the users that go back and forth and that deliver a new experience. And I also like to think that writers are the new designers and that words are the new way of building an identity. It's not the color of the button. It's not what the website looks like. It's not the logo. That doesn't matter. That's just like sugar on top of whatever you're building. What matters is the world, the rhythm, the number of messages you send. So writers are the new designers and words are the new identity. Three ways why I believe that conversation is the future of media. We hear often that content is king. I'd like to think that context is king and that within a conversation, the source of the content doesn't really matter. It can be various, it can come from different type. What matters is that the bot is being, what makes the experience smooth between the content and the user. The user doesn't care where it comes from. What he cares about is that it's good content, tailored for him, and that the bot will bring it in the good context. Context in two different ways. The outside context, say it's the day after a game, it's Valentine's Day, it's the weather is good, or it's very, very cold outside. So that's the outside context. But the inside context is also the context of the person you're talking to and showing them that you know them, that you know that they just got into a relationship and they're going to see a theater play and the weather is nice outside, so you might recommend a nice terrace or a nice rooftop they can go to. So if you recommend the nice rooftop in a context where it's good for them, it's the nice timing, the nice weather, etc., it's way stronger than just, you know, giving them like top 10 rooftops in Paris. That's the chances that it's what you're looking for now are very, very thin. Second of all, inspiration and recommendation. So when readers open a newspaper, a magazine, should it be on paper or online, you don't know where, like what stage of the journey they're in. You don't know if, for instance, if they're looking for trip inspiration, like do they know when they want to go, do they know where they want to go, who is, what's the price. With a bot, you can ask them this question very simply and take them exactly at the right timing of their user journey and give them the best content. So you can be at the very first of the user journey and say, let me show you nice places you could go to this winter. Or if they already know, you can tell them, I know you like this and this, should we send it to your friends? Should I remind you after your week is over that you liked this destination? Okay, now you know where you want to go. Should I show you the map? Should I show you the plane tickets? Should I book an Airbnb? So it really goes with their user journey. And with that, I think the most magical point is the actionability. I don't know if that word exists, but it's the fact of providing an action with the bot. It's not just reading the content, reading the mere information, is all this ecosystem of microservices around the information. So having a reminder, a reservation, being able to pay and book a ticket, going from information, inspiration to action, I think is what makes it really interesting to have this mix of content and actionability. So with Jam, what we're building is the first 100% conversational media. We don't have a blog, we don't have a website. Everything happens on Messenger. It's a media designed for millennials around lifestyle. So all the topics that is the lifestyle. So it's very broad, but it's also very inspiring and people know what it relates to. So coffee shops, food, music, sport, bars and restaurants, but also the news, some games we create, shopping tips, anything around their daily life, and mostly the fun part of it. It's a media you can talk to, and you just talk to it, and it's a media who wants to get to know you and your opinion. So when we talk about interaction, it's not like sugar on top of our product. It's the core of our product. Our product is nothing but a long a dynamic, intimate interaction between one person and its own boat. So it's interactive by design, personalized by design, which is, I think, is key if you want to inspire people and in their everyday life and you want to get to know them and provide them the best content. So interaction by design, personalization by design. So often I'm being asked, like, apps vs. bot, like, are bots going to take over apps? But I think it's the wrong question. The good thing is not to kill apps because it seems more fun to do and just go to your new phase, like, with pure novelty. It's more of a transformation, and I'd like to think that apps are going to be more clever, smarter, because of the conversation. That every app is going to have a conversation model within its core. So I was just wanted to illustrate that with an example of, if you want to go watch a movie this weekend, you can either go on a blog, app, website, and see the movie theaters around you, or you can ask it to a bot, Jam, and he's going to give you the movie theaters around you, ranked according to your tastes. But not only that, but it can ask you, should I remind you that you want to go see this movie? Should I help you buy a movie ticket? Or do you want me to send you the new movie releases every week? Or new sci-fi movies every week? So you're in a completely different mode than just you passively browsing the new movies. And I think we all agree that it's sometimes a bit of a pain to do that. But rather than that, you could get to you, like, have something, someone send to you the movie recommendation every week and then guide you through the journey until you watch the movie. And to conclude with, I just wanted to put a little warning on how, like, it's not yet a new marketing channel. And I'd like to think that it's something more subtle than that, deeper than that. And it's an opportunity not only, and maybe not, to just convert and lower the acquisition cost and make people buy your things. It's an opportunity, on top of all other tools that marketers and entrepreneurs have, to build a deeper, more subtle relationship. And I came up with this metaphor of the bartender. And I think it really illustrates what I have in mind is, you don't go to a bar because of the bartender. You go, I mean, it counts, it matters, but you go to a bar because of the localization, the price, the vibe, the cocktail they have, etc. But if the welcoming is nice, if the bartender is very nice to you and sometimes he gives you shot and he asks you how things are going in your work and in your personal life, and even sometimes he invites you to the after party, you're not dumb. You know he doesn't do that just for pure altruism or to be your friend. But also, he's not, like, selling you things and trying to increase your bill every time he talks to you. It's just another type of relationship. It's not a friend, but it's not a salesman just, like, trying to get more money out of you. And you don't come because of the bartender, but it just changes the dynamic completely in the experience. Everyone's happy with that. It's not just a sales commercial relationship, but it's a relationship that makes the whole experience much better, might make you want to talk to your friends about this bar, come back to this bar, maybe become an accustomed customer. So that's how I perceive bots for marketers, and everyone is more an opportunity to build a deeper relationship, but not just yet another marketing channel. Thank you very much.